Hello friends, welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about this. We already know R of x is a vector space under the operations. Operation is nothing but adding the like term is the first operation, and the second scalar product is just distributing them. Now in this, the subspace is nothing but Pnx, which is defined as set of all polynomials of degree less than or equal to n. Okay, where the coefficients are coming from R and the variable is x, which I wrote over here.
Wait, can you tell me why this Pnx is defined like this? That means, can I define Pnx to be set of all polynomials with degree n only? What will happen then? Yeah?
Okay. Suppose if I define P2x as nothing but set of all polynomials of degree 2, then can it be a subspace of Rx? If you think a bit, you will note that if I define polynomials of degree 2 only, P2x, then my zero polynomial is not an element of it. Hence, it cannot be a subspace. If something is a subspace, then zero must
Correct.
Be an element of
it. So, it's fine. Okay.
Hence, in this case, you can define Pnx as set of all polynomials of degree less than or equal to n. Okay, that less than or equal to n is really important. Okay. Now I want to prove this is a subspace of Rx. We know that. How can we prove it is a subspace? It should be non-empty, it should be subset, it should satisfy that condition. Correct? We know what that condition is. This will be non-empty since we know that the zero polynomial is an element of it. We have defined it in a such a manner that zero is an element of it. Right? So we know that the zero polynomial is there inside it. Hence the given set Pnx is non-empty for any natural number n, right? Small n. So we know that it is non-empty. Also it contains polynomial, hence it is subset also, right? We know it is non-empty subset. Now what we'll do, we will check that alpha w1 bar plus w2 bar is an element of that Pnx, right? So what we consider is, we consider an alpha inside R and P of x and Q of x inside that Pnx, correct?
Wait, just now you told me that Pnx contains all polynomials of degree less than or equal to n. And now you are writing P of x and Q of x as polynomial of degree n. Can you explain it why?
Thus, in this case, you observe, while writing Pnx, I am writing it as a polynomial of degree n. But over here, the coefficients ai are real numbers. They can be 0. It might be possible my an is 0, hence that P of x becomes a polynomial of degree n minus 1. It is simple to write every polynomial in terms of n terms, right? The polynomial of degree n. Correct? So it might be possible it is a constant polynomial. My a1, a2, an, everything is 0. But it is easy to write in this pattern because, as you see, while adding alpha P of x plus Q of x, the polynomial that you are finding over here is coming out to be a polynomial of degree n. It might be possible it goes, the coefficient of x raised to n becomes 0. It is fine. It might be possible coefficient of x raised to n minus 1 is also 0. It is fine. Since we wanted a polynomial of degree less than or equal to n, hence the coefficients become 0, it is okay. But it is not exceeding the degree n. Hence, after doing alpha P of x plus Q of x, the new polynomial, the new element is still inside Pnx. Hence, we can say that my Pnx is a subspace of Rx under that operation. Correct? Thank you so much for watching this video. Share it with your friend and subscribe to my channel.